Welcome friends, this video is about the planet Mercury when it happens to hold the highest degrees in your natal charts, and it is going to be the soul's significator for you. Your soul's desires, your soul's yearnings, what you really want to do in life, and your talents that you possess. So all of these are going to be controlled by the planet Mercury if it holds the highest degrees in your charts. So you are going to be very communicative, you would be very talkative, you would be fond of reading and writing and any kind of literature, whether it is coming through a journal or a magazine or newspaper or any book, you would get attracted towards that and you would want to learn more and more from any kind of knowledge related material, and you would be very fond of writing also, and you may have a vast collection of stationery also. You will always be attracted towards pens or anything with which you can express your thoughts, and you are very good with your hand movements or with your foot movements, and you can be very good in mimicry also, and you are one of those people who can possess a huge library at home, and you would have read each and every book, and you are very knowledgeable also, and you feel very joyful in expressing your knowledge that you have acquired through reading books. So these are some of the very good traits of Atmakaraka Mercury person, and you would be very fond of yoga also, or taking long walks in the laps of nature. You could be very fond of traveling, because traveling gives you a connection with nature, and anything which is green gives you joy and you feel very happy taking long nature walks, and you also like to learn more and more through traveling. So you are one of those people whose learning happens while they travel, and you like to communicate your ideas to others, and as I told you, you have a vast network of friends and relatives who can rely upon you, and you can rely upon these people. But there are times when you may have difference of opinion with these people, and that can stress your mind, and because they are depicting your Atmakaraka, so you should always take their guidance, and it will be of great use to you, because if you listen to their guidance and you listen to their thoughts, that will help you go closer to the area of your enlightenment. Because see, through our Atmakaraka planet only we are going to gain our enlightenment. So through these karakas you should follow their guidelines, and that will help you attain success and reach moksha. So whenever, see, Mercury happens to be your Atmakaraka, you should always pursue those talents which that planet is giving to you, so that you can achieve your enlightenment soon. So see, not everybody is here with the same purpose. Everybody's purpose of soul is different, and that is only to be seen by the planet who is their Atmakaraka. If your soul gets the patronage of your Lagna Lord or your fifth Lord or your Amatya Karak, then it becomes a boon for you, it becomes a blessing for you. You can easily gain the purpose of your soul in this lifetime, and you can come closer to moksha. So this is how you can go about it. So I have collected a vast collection of charts where I can correlate with planet Mercury as their Atmakaraka, and as I told you, Mercury can give you various areas of interest. You can be a very good mimicry artist, you can be a very good artist, you can be a politician, you can be a pilot, you can be a sports person, you can be a big businessman also. But you should always remember that Mercury will always bring lots of adventures and changes in your life, so you should be prepared with that phase of Mercury also, because Mercury gives you lots of changes, and people with Mercury as Atmakaraka do go through many changes in their lives, and life is not the same always for them. So the first example which I want to share with you is of William Shakespeare, whom we all know that he has been one of the greatest masters of English literature, and he was a great actor also and a great poet also and a great writer in English language, and his pieces of literature are also taught in various schools and colleges, and he happened to have Mercury as his Atmakaraka planet, and his Mercury was placed in his 9th house, and his Lagna Lord was Moon. He was having Cancer as his Lagna, and Moon was placed in his 3rd house. So from the 9th house, Mercury was aspecting its own sign of Virgo, and it was also aspecting his Lagna Lord, and Lagna was also aspecting his Atmakaraka. So this made a wonderful combination of Lagna and the Atmakaraka. This gave him a great rise in his life through his writing skills, through his communication skills, and that is how Mercury played a very important role in his life. And see, Moon is all about your thoughts, it's all about your emotions, and Moon being the Lagna Lord was forming a very strong connection with the Atmakaraka Mercury, so he could write very good pieces of literature through this combination in his horoscope. So friends, the other example which I would like to share with you is of Tom Cruise. He's a very well noted actor of modern day times from West, and he happens to have his Atmakaraka Mercury well connected to his Amartyakaraka Venus, and we all know that Venus is all about cinematography and things related to arts and culture. So his Mercury was directly aspecting his Venus, which is his Atmakaraka. So this connection gave him a great rise in his life in the field of cinema, and he's a very accomplished actor and a very, very famous actor from the West. So friends, this is how Mercury is giving him its blessings. And the other example which I have is of Anil Ambani, who is a very noted businessman from India. And Mercury is his Atmakaraka, and it is placed in his 5th house with planet Sun. And Sun is his Amartyakaraka, and Mercury being the Atmakaraka, they are combining in the 5th house itself. And the 5th Lord, which in itself is a very good combination, 5th Lord Jupiter is aspecting from the 11th house to both these planets. So this forms a triple Raj Yoga. When the fifth Lord, the Atmakaraka and Amartyakaraka, they three are connected, then it forms a Raj Yoga. So he got lots of accomplishment in the field of business. He is a noted businessman. But as I told you, Mercury does bring lot of changes in somebody's life by being the Atmakaraka. So his life did go through lots of changes, and currently his business is not doing that well, and he is facing some issues. So that's all because of the Atmakaraka Mercury, which did give him some changes, some ups and downs in his life. The other example which I have is of Rajiv Gandhi. So Rajiv Gandhi is our ex prime minister, our late prime minister from India, and he has got a wonderful Raj Yoga in his Lagna itself, and Mercury is his Atmakaraka planet situated in the Lagna with the 5th Lord, that is his Jupiter. So this forms a wonderful Raj Yoga in Lagna, and after he was born, his maternal grandfather, late Jawaharlal Nehru, he became the Prime Minister of India when his mother, Mrs. Indira Gandhi, was carrying him, and before his birth, the good things started happening, and after his birth, Jawaharlal Nehru became the Prime Minister of India, and Indira Gandhi also became the Prime Minister of India after his birth. So his birth itself was very, very auspicious for the entire family, for his maternal grandfather also, and for his mother also. And later on, he also took over as Prime Minister of India, and the entire family is quite blessed because of this combination through his birth, which happened in his lagna. So why I took his example, because see, Mercury being the Atmakarak is also the significator of travel, and he was a very good pilot, and his Atmakarak Mercury gave him those abilities, and because it is in very good dignity, so he could follow that path of being a pilot. So friends, these are some of the examples. Yeah, and I happen to remember one more example, which is of a very very famous biologist, or you can say a doctor, Charles Darwin. He gave us the theory of evolution, and he was born about 200 years ago. He was born in 1809, and he also went through lots of changes in his life, and his Atmakarak was also Mercury, and his initial childhood was not very smooth, and he quit his studies when he was studying medicine. He quit it in between because he was too much a nature lover, and he wanted to travel across the nature to study about nature and species, and he is considered as one of the greatest travelers and lovers of nature, and he is the one who discovered the theory of evolution, and he brought forth to the world that those species which are more evolved tend to do better and they survive, and those species which are less evolved, they eventually die and they can't survive. So this kind of theory he brought forward to the world. This is because of his Atmakarak Mercury. It gave him love for nature and love for travel. And the interesting part is that his Mercury is present in his fourth house. Atmakarak Mercury is in his fourth house, and the fourth lord has gone to its third house. So I will explain to you what it means. See, fourth house is for education, and the fourth lord has gone to the third house of travel. So while traveling, he did his studies of nature, of species, and with the help of his Atmakarak Mercury, he brought forward to the world that what is the theory of evolution all about. So friends, studying the Atmakarak planet becomes very interesting and very important for you to note the desires of your soul, to note the areas of your strengths, and by studying upon the kind of Amatyakarak that you are having, that is the planet holding the second highest degrees, you can follow the inclinations or the talents that you have with the help of your Amatyakarak and reach towards enlightenment. And everybody has a different Atmakarak and Amatyakarak. You should be able to recognize these two planets and follow their path and take their help and listen to their karkas, and then the life becomes very smooth for you. And just in case you happen to have a weak Mercury, in that case you should do the chanting of the Beech Mantra of Mercury. That will be very helpful for you. Om Brahm Brim Brom Saha Buddhaya Namaha. So you should recite this mantra daily for 108 times. This will help you strengthen your Mercury if you happen to have Mercury as your Atmakara. And you should always listen to the guidance of your cousins and your younger siblings. This will be very beneficial for you. So friends, this was all about planet Mercury as Atmakarak. So if you think it was a worthwhile video, I would request you to like, subscribe and share. And I want to thank you all for listening. I'll come up with more interesting videos very soon in future. So thank you, friends.